you've still had no luck with regards to your sleep. That is a shame to hear. Well, you're booked in for two evenings, and we will try our absolute best to assist you in figuring out what it is that's going wrong. Alright. Oh my lovely, it's okay. I know how stressful it can be. To struggle with sleep. Okay. Well, I'm gonna take a little bit of info first, and then we're gonna get you prepped, okay? So if you don't mind, I'm wanting to do a little bit of a health check, just a small one, just so I can make sure that you're definitely in tip-top shape and nice and healthy, okay? Alright, my lovely. So, let's just write down your info on this form, so first and last name, please. Okay, and your date of birth. Thank you. Okay, so when was it that you first had these sleep problems? So it's been quite a long time. Okay, and have they progressively gotten worse, or have they been consistent? Progressively worse. Bless you. Okay. Is there any way that you can combat them? Have you tried sleeping pills, earplugs, eye masks, ASMR, meditations? None of those have helped. Okay. And how would you categorize your sleep issue? Would you say it's predominantly insomnia, night terrors, sleepwalking? Yeah, I've suffered with insomnia for years, so I definitely sympathize. Can be quite painful, can't it? Yeah, because it does take a few days to recover. Do you find that? Bless you. Yeah. So this really has been an ongoing problem for years. Have you found any at any time things have gotten a bit better? Okay. And how would you categorize your overall lifestyle? Do you spend a lot of time sort of sitting down at the computer, or are you quite active? Okay, could you sleep on your own or with your partner? Okay. Alright. So, my lovely, what we'll do is we'll do a few different health tests, just simple ones, to make sure you're nice and healthy before we submit you into one of the treatment rooms, okay? So, and then just make sure that you're nice and responsive still, okay? So, lift up your top for me. Just have a little listen to your heart first. Are you experiencing any deep breath in for me. Good. Okay, and then deep breath out. And again, deep breath in for me. And then out. Okay. Just coming around the back. Okay, deep breath in again for me. Again, deep breath in and out. Great, well done. That's great. All right, that's great. I don't see any problems there at all. If you could just lift up your sleeve. I'm just gonna put this on your arm. Is that comfortable? It should be a little bit tight, but not too much. Okay. Remove that. Okay, I'm all happy with that. Just wanting to make a note of those so we have them on file. So then if anything does change over your stay, we can monitor it. If you have experienced high blood pressure before, so I have this little pulse oximeter here, and I'm just gonna pop this on your finger like this, press this button, and it's gonna take your BPM in a few seconds. Okay, just relax, pop that in there, doesn't hurt or anything. Okay, and we'll just give it a few seconds. Got blood oxygen of 96 and BPM currently of 82. Oh, you're a little bit nervous. Oh, bless you. It's okay. I know that you are obviously in a lot of discomfort, pain, stress, but there is absolutely nothing to worry about. We'll make sure to take very good care of you. We've got a big team of wonderful doctors here. Will take really good care of you, I promise. Okay. If any time as well, there's any sort of food, snacks, drinks, anything that you want, we'll go and get that for you. Okay. But of course, we need to monitor you from evening to evening and then the morning. So you will be spending the full day with us tomorrow. I hope that's okay. We'll have plenty to keep you busy. All right. What we usually actually do is we will put on a lot of sort of mental physical activities for you so that you're very stimulated through the day, so that we know that, you know, you've been very active, burnt a lot of calories, moved around, used your body efficiently, so that we know that, you know, you should be efficiently tired, so the insomnia is coming from problem and not just you being lazy. Yeah, okay, so where were we? Let's finish the examination and then I'm gonna prep a little bit and pop some electrodes on you, okay? Alright. So, I just want to have a little look in your eyes if you don't mind, just because I want to check your responsiveness, make sure that you are dilating correctly, you can follow fingers because because of course insomnia can affect brain capacity and function, okay? So, you just stay completely still, look at my nose or the wall behind me. I've got this little torch and I'm just going to be shining it in your eyes, okay? Don't look at the torch and just try and relax, okay? Dilation here. You're doing a really great job. A bit uncomfortable to have the light shining in your eyes. Alright, I just want to check your responsiveness, okay? So I'm going to ask you now to follow my finger. So, keeping your head nice and still and just using your eyes, alright? Going in. I'm happy with that. Do you wear glasses or contacts at all? Okay. Okie dokie. Right. So I'm happy with my assessment now. Again, just to preface, you don't have any ongoing illnesses at the moment, and you're not on any medication. Okay, great. Can I ask what you've been up to today? Sounds lovely. Okay. So hopefully you'll get a really nice, good night's sleep tonight. Okay. So, I'm gonna give you a candle to put into the room. You can choose whether or not you'd like it. Let me just go. Just a little extra, just in case you wanted some sort of relaxing scent and atmosphere in the room. This is Ginger and Raya White Pomelo. Yes, of course, right. I will light this up for you. Now. Okay, so I'm going to pop that in the corner of the room, and completely up to you, but I can give you a little bit of relaxation before. I can just do a little bit of skincare on you. Give your face a cleanse and moisturize. It'll make you feel nice and calm before bed. Okay. little bit of cleanser. Using all lavender scented products as well today, which just helps boost the relaxation. Okay. And then I'm going to be taking this Mineral 89 by Vichy. This is purifying, fortifying, and plumping daily booster. This is really high. Wake up in the morning with a really nice hydrated skin. Okay. So, we're all done. I'm now going to pop the electrodes on you, okay? We're going to be needing quite a few. And then when you go into your sleep room, we'll be plugging you in with wires, okay? I know you've been through this all before. Forehead here. And then the other side of your forehead. Do a few behind your ears. Maybe just grab a fresh pack. Do two more on your temples here. And these will just measure brainwave activity. Okay. Comfortable. I know it can feel a little almost like you're in space. A bit sci-fi. Alright, well, if you're all comfy and ready, I'm going to escort you to the sleep room now. That will be your room for the duration of your stay, okay? What we'll do is I'll get you wired up. Gonna leave a nice ASMR relaxation music and track for you, okay? Right. Alright. Follow me. Are you okay? Yeah. Well, I'm Dr. Michelle. Responding correctly. Thank you so much for joining me today. Your name is... Well, it's lovely to meet you. So I think you've already had a little bit of a briefing about what's gonna happen today, right? So basically, I'm currently being assessed. I'm going through my training and practice to become a medical GP. Thank you. So today we're basically doing a little bit of practice on you, if you don't mind. Assuming you don't mind. And I'm just going to be going through a few different medical examinations with you today, which should be about 20-30 minutes of your time, if that's alright. I do have my notes with me, just to go through everything, just so I want to make sure I don't miss checking anything. So this is currently being recorded, just so that my assessor can look back on it and give me any tips before the actual assessment. We've got about 3 more weeks beforehand, and I just want to get as much practice as I possibly can. Anyway, so I will put the Dr. GP brain on now. I'm just going to begin by asking you a few questions, okay? So firstly, could I get your first and last name, please? Thank you. This is assuming that you haven't already been checked in at reception, which usually you would have done. And your date of birth. Wonderful. Okay. And is there anything that you are coming in with, any issues in particular today? Right, okay. So you've just been feeling generally under the weather. Okay. Do we have any pre-existing medical conditions? I'll start that again. Do you have any pre-existing medical conditions that I should be aware of? Are you currently on any sort of medication? And was that prescribed at this GP practice? Okay, so we should have a record of that. General overall health questions. If I could ask you to rate your health from 1 to 10, 1 being the worst health that you could be in, 10 being the best possible health, where would you rate yourself currently on the scale? Okay, great healthy health scale, nice. Okay, are you partaking in a lot of physical activity? Do you consider yourself a very active person? And what kind of sports do you like to take? I do love walking. Okay, great. And how about your diet? Would you consider yourself somebody that tries to eat 5 fruits and vegetables a day, having whole grain, avoiding sort of, you know, really high processed fast foods as much as you can? Good. That's always great to hear. Okay, and could you, or are you at all pregnant? Are you currently taking any non-prescription medication? Yeah, that's included any sort of recreational drug use. And finally, your alcohol consumption. Okay. Great, I think I've covered all the questions that I need to. So I'm gonna begin just having a general look over you, and then we will do sort of a little bit of a cranial nerve. I'm gonna be looking at your eyes, looking inside your ears, down the back of your throat, feeling your lymph nodes, and then I will have a look at your, listen to your chest, listen to your lungs, heart rate, blood pressure, and I think then we should be about good to go. Yeah? Okay, so I'm gonna start off with just a scalp examination. I'm just gonna have a little look. Oh, let me pop on some gloves first, 1 second. Gloves before I touch a patient. Sometimes I can get a little bit overexcited towards work and forget. How are you doing today anyway? You having a good day? Good. Okay, and at any time at all, if you feel uncomfortable with anything or you want me to stop or you have any questions, please let me know. Okay, so I'm gonna have a look at your scalp first. So what I'm doing here is just moving the hair slightly. Just to check the overall. Make sure it's looking all nice and healthy. Do you feel any soreness? No? Okay. Let me just look at your facial symmetry. No puffiness, swelling. All good. Do we have good sensitivity in the face? Can you feel when I'm touching you? Yeah. Good. Have you been experiencing any sort of headaches at all? No? Great. I think we're all good there. Okay. Let's begin with began our examination. Now I'm going to remove the gloves, seeing as I'm not going to be touching your face now. Campfire find gloves quite uncomfortable as well, so I'm glad to not have to wear those throughout the exam. Okay, so let me just make a quick note. I checked the scalp. No sort of skin issue. No headache complaint. Symmetry. Okay,
that'll do for now.
So next we're going to move on to our eye examination. I'm going to begin by taking my torch here and looking into your eyes to check your pupil dilation. Then we will move on to the Snellen chart to get you to read some letters out for me to see where your vision currently sits on the chart. Then I will be doing a few different peripheral tests. Okay?
Okay.
So, I'm just going to come a little bit closer to you. I want you to just keep your head still and look behind me. Try not to focus too much on the light, okay? Okay. It's not irritating you at all. Very windy outside today, isn't it? Okay, I think I'm happy with that.
Great.
So, pupil dilation. Okay. So, I'm going to use my pen to point down the chart, and I just want you to read back to me, okay? So we'll start with those eyes first. Good. Mm-hmm. Good. Good. Keep going. And now could we do the same, but could you cover this eye for me? Ready? Good. Mm-hmm. Good, keep going. Starting to struggle a bit here. Okay. Keep trying for me. We'll just try this last line to see if you can read. Switching to the other eye. Okay, I'll do this one last time. Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. Good. Okay. Good. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Just trying again, okay. Try a bit more for me. I think we could try the next line. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You did really well. Alright, are you currently wearing contacts at all? You are, so you wear contacts and glasses. Okay, so I would suggest that you do look in to see an optometrist, because you should be hurting a little bit more around this sort of area, especially with wearing your prescription contacts. So you might need a review on those, because we shouldn't really be struggling at this marker here. Right, but nothing too serious to worry about. Okay, now I'm going to move on to your peripheral vision. So I want you to just keep your head still for me, and I'd like you to use just your eyes to follow my finger around the room. Okay? Good. Good. So we're checking the eye's ability to follow together in sequence, making sure there is no laziness in either eye. Also checking the contraction of the pupil with distance. Great. Okay, so keeping your head still again for me, I'm going to be bringing my hands in to your field of vision, and I would simply like you to tell me when you can see them. Okay. Good. And again. Good. This is my favourite part. Good. And again. Good. Okay. Up on the side. Good. One more time. Good. Okay. Other side. Good. One more. Great. Okay. So I'm really happy with that. So we did a little finger. And peripheral. All of which seem very healthy. Okay. So I'm just going to a little look inside your mouth now, if you don't mind. Okay, so if you just open your mouth and say, "Ah," I'm just going to have a look at the back of your throat. Okay. That's it, say, "Ah." Oh, you've had your tonsils taken out. Okay. That all seems perfectly healthy. Are you suffering with any sort of colds, coughs, sniffly noses at the moment? No? Do you feel like you've got a clear nose at the moment? Wonderful. Okay, and then I'm just going to have a quick look inside your ear. I don't have my otoscope at the moment, so we're just going to have to do with the light. Just have a quick look in there. Are you struggling with any sort of hearing at all? No? Okay, well, from what I can see, this feels lovely and healthy. I'm just gonna look on your other side here. And again, no problems, no feeling of earwax buildup. No? Okay, great. They both seem lovely and healthy. I'm just going to do a very quick hearing examination with you. I'm going to be placing my two hands on either side of your ears. I'm going to be scratching my thumbs like this, and I want you to just tell me if it is your left or right ear that you can hear it in, okay? So if you could just close your eyes, no cheating. Okay, ready? Good. Okay. You passed with flying colours. So, ear, hearing. Great. canal. From what I can see.
Okay, so
we just want to... I've used my gloves. I'm gonna have to put another pair on, aren't I? Yeah, I'm gonna have to put another pair on. Unfortunately, I think they would fail me if I didn't put another pair on. So, let's just put them on for good measure. Feel around your neck, just palpate along here. Just have a feel of your lymph nodes, your glands, whichever you'd like to call them. No soreness at all. Great. I'll take these off again. Ah, in fact, you know, just for the few last little ones, I'm sure I'll just keep them on. I do need to palpate your chest as well, so probably just best keeping them on. In which case, could you just lift your top up for me? Thank you. Okay, so I'm gonna just have a little listen to your chest. To make sure everything is going nice and healthy. So, could you just breathe normally for me? I'm just gonna have a listen. Okay. Okay, could you do, give me a deep breath in, please? And out. Good, and just one more time, deep breath in. And out. Okay, I'm just going to reach around the back. Okay, give me a deep breath in, please. And out. And in. Really happy with that. Let me just make a note. So lungs sounding healthy. No sort of rattling. Fluid. Great. I'll just quickly palpate just to check any fluid. I'm just going to be pressing my two fingers and tapping on the other side, just hearing for any sort of echoing. Okay, I'm just going around the back and doing that again. Just two more things. I want to just take your heart rate. Just using this little clip I've got here, I'm just going to clip it onto your finger like this. Okay. for a moment just to have a look. It's just a simple pulse oximeter. It's just going to take your BPM. Sort of like a health watch. Okay. We are at 65 beats per minute, resting heart rate, which is very healthy. Finally, I am just going to be taking up blood pressure, so I'm going to pop this cap on. Is that comfy? Okay, I'm just going to watch the meter. All healthy there. I guess I can remove my gloves now. Is there anything else at all that is troubling you today? Okay, so in that case, let me just make a note. Your blood pressure was perfectly healthy, by the way. So we're all good there. Okay, and if we've got no other issues, then we're all done today. So again, I am wanting to suggest that you do go to an optometrist when you can, just because it seems as though your contact lenses are not up to where they should be in terms of providing aid with vision. You definitely need to be revisiting that prescription. And otherwise, you're very healthy. And it was a pleasure having you here with me today. Thank you so much. I'm hoping that it was helpful to me as well. I found it very helpful. I do need to remember the glove situation. It's definitely something I've remembered today. And I don't think I've missed anything either. So, yeah, thank you so much for joining me today. And I'll see you very soon. Okay. Bye. Okay. Right. Do you remember gloves? Hi. Thank you so much for coming in. I really appreciate it. I'm in my final year of practice before I can become a GP. And if I'm correct, just confirming, you've said that it's okay for me to practice on you today. Yeah, thank you. I really appreciate it. I have my assessments in about 3 weeks' time, so anything could pretty much crop up, but today, if you don't mind, I felt like what would be best is for me to do a full examination, so pretty much from top to bottom, covering all bases, or as many as I can remember. Is that okay with you? Thank you. Okay, so it's just a formality, but I'm going to just take a couple of notes so I can remind myself where I'm at, and also I need to start with some questions as well. So could I have your first and last name, please? Thank you. And what's your date of birth? Okie dokie. Is there anything in particular physically that is troubling you today? Anything that you'd like us to focus on, pay particular attention to? No? All feeling healthy? Good. Okay. So I'm going to ask you a few questions about your health and general activity. So what is it that you do as an occupation? Okay. And how often are you doing sort of physical exercise with that job? Are you on your feet a lot or behind a computer? And other than work, how would you rate your physical activity? So do you regularly get out for walks? How about any sports you play? Going to the gym? You do a bit of weight training. Okay, and how often do you go to the gym? Great. How about cardiovascular endurance? Are you into running or any sort of cardio? Do you experience asthma at all? Are you currently on any medication? Okay. And regarding your eating habits, would you say that you eat well? You're getting lots of fruit and vegetables, fiber, balanced diet, lots of protein. Yep. Good. Okay, how about processed food? Do you eat those regularly? Okay. And how about water? Are you drinking at least 2 liters of water a day? Good. Okay, and then recreational drugs. Are you partaking in any? And how about smoking? And how regularly? Okay. How about alcohol? How many units a week would you say you drink? Okie dokie. How would you rate your sleep? Would you say that you feel well rested? You get between 6 to 8 hours of sleep a night? And a final question, how would you rate your stress levels from day to day? Would you say that you live quite a high stress lifestyle, job, or would you say that you are more sort of low stress? And how do you manage that? Okay, that's all my questions for now. So I will be picking my notebook back up again just to make some notes throughout if I feel like I need to. Basically I'm going to be working from top to bottom, as I said before, just so I can go through everything sort of in chronological order. Okay, I'm just going to prep myself. So I'm putting on some hand gel to kill any bacteria on my hands. To keep you nice and safe. And then I'm going to be popping on a pair of latex-free examination gloves. just adds an extra layer of protection. But we begin with the hand sanitizing gel so that I'm not putting my germs on to the gloves themselves before touching you. I also have some cleaning moist wipes with me. So if I am examining any particular part of the skin, I may use them just to cleanse the area first, okay? Great, okay, so I'm going to start with your head, obviously. I want to have a look at your scalp first, if that's okay. Okay, so I'm going to just gently move your hair out of the way and just give your scalp a little bit of a brush. Do you experience any sort of scalp irritation, dryness, dandruff? Are you on to dye your hair? I can tell. You dyed it recently. There is still a little bit of staining left on the skin. Okay, overall, feeling nice and healthy. Nothing is hurting when I'm touching it. No? Okay, I'm just going to have a little touch of your skin. Let me know if any places are hurting at all. I'm just having a feel. Make sure it feels nice and firm and hydrated. You said that you get a lot of water in your day. That's really good, especially for anti-aging, preventative aging. So, for headaches as well, if we keep on top of our water, we're much less likely to experience headaches. Do you experience headaches at all? Okay. So, yeah, I'm just going to make a note of that. Have you ever been diagnosed with migraines? Do you take any medication for that? How do you usually cope with it? Okay. Okay, regardless, skin feels firm, good elasticity, and moisture. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Now, next I'm going to be doing a little bit of a skin sensitivity test. Make sure that you can tell the difference in your nerve endings. Okay, so firstly I'm going to test to make sure that you know where the feeling is coming from in your face, so that your nerves are sort of connecting up to your brain, if that makes sense. Just a little bit new with trying to describe in layman's terms. I'm finding that a bit difficult. Okay, so I have this little device. This basically blows a little bit of cold air. So what I want you to do is I want you to close your eyes for me, and I'm going to blow some air into different spots on your face, and I want you to tell me where it is that you feel that. Is that okay? Great, okay, close your eyes. Good. it. You can open your eyes. Okay, next test I'm going to do is a little bit similar, but instead a little sharp object here, I just grab cotton bud. I'm going to be asking you to close your eyes again, and I'm going to be poking your face with either the sharp metal or the soft cotton bud. And I want you to tell me which is which, okay? So for reference, this is the sharp, and this is the dull. Alright? Okay, so close your eyes again for me. Good. Okay, you can open your eyes for me. Thank you, that's all great. Let me just make a note. Okay. Moving on, I just want to test the strength of your facial muscles now. So we ask you to do a few exercises. I first want you to pull a few faces for me. So could you first puff out your cheeks for me? Keep going. Okay, good. And then could you frown for me? Just testing the eyebrows. Strength, good. Okay. Could you stick out your tongue? Give a big smile. Good. And could you open your mouth as wide as you can? Good. Keep your mouth open. I'm going to try and shut your jaw, and I want you to stop me from doing so, okay? Okay, great. And then I'm going to just test your mobility. So if you could just push against my hand. Good. Down the other side. Push against my hand. And then try to tilt your head back. And then put your chin to your chest. Okie dokie. We've done all of your facial muscles and nerve sensitivity, so I suppose we're moving on to your eyes now. If I could just get you to draw your attention to the Snellen jar here. I'm going to do a quick Snellen examination and then we'll go through the eyes, okay? Alright. Of course, this is not an optician, so I will only be doing a brief eye examination. If you do have any problems with your eyes, I definitely suggest you go to see a proper optician, okay? But we can just have a little play around, just to make sure that your vision is okay. Alright, so if I point to a letter, if you could just read it out for me. Okay. Good. 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 That's great. Okay, and if you could just close one eye for me, I'm going to now pay attention to this side of the chart, and I want you to tell me what direction the E is facing. So, for example, this is up, this is down, we've got your left and right, okay? Alright. Good. Good. Good, okay. Covering this eye and covering this one. We're going to do the same again. Okay. Very good. Okay, I'm happy with that. Okay, next I'm going to be testing your ability to follow and track with your eyes. I want you to keep your head completely still for me, and I want you to just follow with your eyes the pen around the room. Okay? Just keep following the pen. Good. Okay. Right. Then we're going to be testing your field of vision. So I want you to keep your head still again, focusing this time on the wall behind me or at my nose. Up to you. And I'm going to be bringing my hands into your field of vision. And I want you to tell me when you can start to see my hands. Okay? Good. 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 Okay. We're going to cover one eye. We're going to do all that again. All right. So again, keeping your head straight and focusing on the wall or my nose. Okay. Good. Good. Great. And then switching eyes for me. Okay. Good. Irritation? Get tired or dry eyes? Do you wear glasses or contacts? Okay. What do we have next? I'm just going to check your pupil dilation, finally, with your eyesight. And then I think we'll move on to the nose. Is that okay? Great. So, again, if you could stare at either the wall behind me or at my nose, I'm going to be bringing in this light into your field of vision. I don't want you to look directly at the light at all. I'm just going to be checking for your pupil dilation. Okay. Mm-hmm. So your pupil should contract and dilate depending on the light. All right. Good. Okay, good. Does that feel okay? We're doing the other eye now. Again, did that feel okay? Okay, I'm actually going to keep my torch on, so we're going to move on to the nose. I'm just going to shine this light up your nose a little so I can have a look. Okay, I know. So just lift your head a little for me. Okay, good. And I'm just going to have a little bit of a feel of the nose, feel of the cartilage. Do you suffer from any breathing problems? Do you experience sleep apnea? Do you ever feel like your breathing is restricted? Okay. I'm going to do a very quick smell. I'm going to do a very quick smell test with you. Just have one scent here. And what I want you to do is I want you to block each nostril and smell this liquid and tell me what you think the smell is, okay? So if we start with blocking this one. Okay, and give a sniff. Okay, and give a sniff. What do you think that is? Good, vanilla. Okay. And just tell me for reference, does it smell the same on the other side? That was easy, wasn't it? So, moving on from the nose now to the ears and then the mouth. So, I'm just wanting to have a little look inside your ears. I have my otoscope with me here. And this just helps me to see clearly into your ears, okay? So, we'll start on this side. Okay, so, having a look inside your ears now. Do you have any particular issues with hearing at all? No, you don't experience people trying to repeat what they've said. Mm-hmm. You always feel like you can clearly hear when someone's speaking. Good, okay. How about earwax buildup? Do you find that is a common? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Have you ever been to an ear clinic? Well, I can see quite a little bit of earwax, so I would definitely suggest it. I'm just going to have a quick feel around the actual ear itself. Again, checking the cartilage, making sure that it's nice and thick. Okay, all happy with that. We'll move on to the other ear here. Okay. So again, any hearing on this side, any hearing issues? No, not that you know of. Okay. And then I can see some earwax build up here as well. Okay, I'm just gonna check the cartilage again. That you've had ear cleanings before, yes. I would definitely recommend that you are due another one very soon. I can see quite a lot of earwax build up. It looks quite compacted as well. Are you using earbuds to clean? You are. I would definitely recommend not doing that. Of course, it's up to your own discretion, but it does make the wax more compacted, so when you are needing an ear cleaning, it's a much more thorough, difficult job, and it can leave your ears quite sore. Okay. Alright. Okay, I'm just going to make a few notes here. I think we'll do a little quick hearing test, if you don't mind. It doesn't require a lot. Basically, I'm gonna make this noise by your ears, and I'm gonna slowly move my hands away, and I want you to tell me at which point you can no longer hear the noise. Okay? And we're going to do it just on one side now. Okay, and the other side. Good. Okay, now I want you to close your eyes for me. I'm going to be making the same sound again in your ears, but I'm going to be doing it from different sides, and I want you to tell me whether it's your left or your right ear. Okay, so close your eyes. Good. With your ear examination, we are complete with the head portion. Okay, so I'm gonna take my gloves off now. And we're gonna move on to checking all of your vitals, and then we'll end off with a strength test. Is that okay? I know you've been so patient with me, I really, really appreciate it. So first, I want to just take your heart rate. I have this little heart rate monitor. If I could just pop this on your finger like this, and press the button, and it's going to read your heart rate. Okay? So. It should just take a few seconds. Okay, so we're currently sitting at 81. That's a little high for resting. But at the same time, you are engaging with me, so I would assume that it was because you are very switched on right now.
Let me just make a note of 81 BPM. Okie dokie. Next, I want to have a listen to your lungs. Okay. Just take my stethoscope here, and if you could just lift up your top for me. I'm going to have a little bit of a listen, okay? So, if you just want to breathe normally for me for now, and I'm just going to have a bit of a listen. I'm still finding this bit a little difficult to know what to listen for. Sounds fine to me. Could you do a few deep breaths in and out for me? Just like that. And in. And out. In. Gonna reach around the back. Alright, and again, just breathe in normally for me for a moment. Okay, and then deep breath in for me. And out. In. One more time, in and out. Okay, very good. That's all great. Very happy with that. Your lungs are sounding very, very healthy. Pop up there. I just want to do a quick palpation on your stomach just to make sure that I'm not hearing any hollowness or liquid. So if you just keep your top rolled up, thank you. I'm just going to be patting on your stomach, okay? Just let me know if it hurts anytime. All right. Do you suffer from any constipation at all? Difficulties going to the toilet? No? Okay, any bloating or IBS? Okay, so we've done the heart, the lungs, and the stomach. I'm just going to take your blood pressure, if you don't mind. And then we should be. I just want to do a little bit of a strength test with you as well. Okay, so let me just grab my blood pressure cuff here. Okie dokie. So, do you have an arm that you prefer? Just lay your hand flat for me. Yeah, just relax. remove that cuff. Okay, blood pressure is all great as well. You're very fighting fit, aren't you? Okay, so let's finish with a strength test. So what I want you to do is I want you to just grab hold of my hands, just like this. And I want you to briefly squeeze as hard as you can. Good, okay. I just want to have a look at your palms. Checking mobility of the fingers. Do you have any grip strength issue? A little. Mm-hmm. Do you find that issue at the gym? Mm-hmm. Yeah. I find that a lot as well because my hands are so small. It's so difficult to actually get a good grip on the bar. Okay, and how about the wrists? Okay, the other hand, finger mobility. The wrist. Okay, I'm going to press my hands like this, and I want you to go in between my hands and try and push my hands out. Okay. Good. And now the other way around. Go inside. I want you to try and push my hands in while I push out. Okay. Good. And if you just push against my hands. Good. Okie dokie. Right. I think I'm happy with that. I'm gonna take my notes to my tutor, and this session's been recorded, so basically he will watch back and see what I've missed, but otherwise I think we've done a pretty good job. Thank you so much for being my guinea pig today. I really appreciate it. The more that we can sort of have practice, the more we're used to sort of routine checkups, and then we know, you know, what we're supposed to be doing, what we're looking for. Definitely I would suggest you go and get an ear cleaning. That was sort of my big highlight of the day, but otherwise I think you're fighting fit. So yeah. Oh no, thank you so much. Alright, I'll see you soon. Hi, come in, relax, take a seat. My name is Sophie, I'm going to be your optometrist for today. It's a pleasure to meet you. Now, I believe that you've been having some difficulties with your eyes, is that correct? Okay. What is it specifically that you're finding some issues with? Okay, so you believe you might be a little bit colorblind. Right. Okay. What kind of colors is it that you find difficult to differentiate between? Mm-hmm. Okay, I see. So it's less of a differentiation, more of a weakness with certain colors. Right, okay. Okay, interesting. So we'll definitely have a little look at that. We'll have a look at your eye health, and I'll get you in for a photograph and a scan of your eyes as well after this appointment, okay? Otherwise, eyesight-wise, are you feeling that you can see with clarity? Are you wearing glasses at the moment? No, no contacts. Okay.
Not any glasses for reading either, or strain. None at all. Okay. Okay. So you believe you've got pretty good vision so far. Okay. Sounds good. Right, so what I want to do first, if you don't mind, is I want to examine your eye and around your eye, just physically looking at the overall eye holes around it. Is that okay? So I'm going to be coming up a little bit close and just having a feel of under the eye socket, seeing the quality of the tear ducts, looking, lifting the lids. Okay. I'm going to make sure that my hands are nice and clean. So first, I'll just grab some hand sanitizer. Okay, and I'll pop some gloves on for good measure as well. Do a little bit of palpation onto the eyes here. Does that hurt at all when I'm pressing like that? Okay, continuing on. Your lids slightly. Do you suffer from dry eyes at all? Happy with that. In that case, we can remove these. So you said it's sort of blue and orange. These are your dominating colours. Okay. Right. So what I will do first is let's do a general overall health checkup. We'll do the basics, get you to read out from the Snellen chart, then we'll have a look at your peripheral vision, ability to track and follow. Yeah? But first I just want to check your pupil dilation. So, I have my torch with me. If you could just look behind me, try not to look at the light, just because it can be a little bit dazzling. Mm-hmm. seems perfectly healthy. Right, so if I could draw your attention to the saline chart here. I'm just going to be pointing to some letters and I want you to simply read them out for me, okay? So we'll start off with both eyes. Alright. Good. Keep going. Good. Keep going. Good. You're doing a really good job. Check you out. Keep going. Can you keep going? Try one more line. Yeah. That's great. So, if you want to cover your right eye first, and let's start here, okay? Good. And again, good, well done. Well done, you got all those right. Switching eyes now, covering the left eye this time. Okay. We'll start from here again, okay? Good. Deep. Good. Can you keep going? Yeah. E. Try again. Yeah. F. Good. Last line to try. Try your best. Well done. That's great. So it seems as though both of your eyes are reading at the same level. That's really good. Okay, so let's try your eye tracking now. So the ability for your eyes to both focus and keep direction with each other in sequence. Okay? So I want you to keep your head nice and still for me. And with just your eyes, I want you to follow my finger around the room. Ready? Good. Good job. Keep going. Good. Well done. Good. Okay. I'm going to introduce the light this time. So I'm going to be tracking the finger and light at the same time, and I want you to continue to focus on my finger and try not to be distracted by the light, okay? Keeping that head still again. Keep going. Good. Well done, that was really good. Great focus. Okay, we're all done with the light. Now I want you to keep your head nice and still for me again. And keep focused on one spot, so whether it's my nose or the back wall. And I'm going to be bringing my hands into your field of vision. Okay? I want you to tell me when you can start to see them. Alright? Okay, keeping that head nice and still. Good. Great. Good. 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 Keep it going. Okay, now we're going to cover one eye. Let's start with your right eye. I'm going to do exactly the same again. Okay, I'm going to cover my eye as well, just so I can see the same as what you do. Okay, ready? Good. Good, well done. Okay, switching that eye over. So we're starting with this eye now. Okay, same again. Good. Good. Yes. Great. And now the other side. Good. Good. Great. Well done. That was really good. Okay, I want you to again stare just at my nose or the wall behind me. Keep your head nice and still. This time I'm going to be popping up a few different numbers with my fingers. And I want you to tell me how many I'm holding up, okay? Okay, both eyes now. Okay, ready? Good. Yes. Good. That's really great. Okay, so let's have a little look at your colorblindness now. Just want to have a brief look whereabouts on the spectrum you are. So, I'm going to be holding up some simple colored pencils and I want you to simply tell me what color that you see. Just doing this so that I can see and reconfirm the color difficulty that you're having. Okay, ready? Okay. 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 Definitely see where you're coming from. Okay, so finally, just because I have noticed, based on your records, you were previously able to read the bottom line, and you said you're no longer able to. So what I want to do is just go through a couple of lenses with you, just to see if you feel that they may be a better fit for you. Something that you feel you may have a benefit towards. Okay. You still have very, very good vision, but it may feel as though sometimes when you're straining a lot, if you're in front of a computer, or if you're, you know, really focused, like driving, you may benefit from a little bit of assistance. I don't think that you have perfect vision, but it is not severe enough for you to be wearing permanent glasses. Alright? So let's just see if any of these are any assistance to you. So, I have these snazzy little glasses with me. They are very snazzy, as I'm sure you'll agree. And I'm just gonna pop a few lenses in there, ask you to look at the chart again, and see if they help. Alright, so I'll just fit these on you. That's great. Are they comfortable? Okay. I'll open up my box of lenses. So I believe that we will be just starting at the lower strength, going up a little. We should only be using 2 or 3, maybe. So first we have 0.25. Okay, just taking a look here at the Snellen chart. Is that looking better or worse? So we'll say without. Here's 1. And away there's 2. Real change. Okay. So now we have 2, which is the one you just had. 2 or 3. Okay. 2 or 3. Once more. 3. Maybe 2. Okay, popping 3 back. Okay, moving up 2.75. This is now 4. We have 2 and 4. Okay. So back to 2, 4. 2 or 4. Final time. 2 or 4. Still 2. Great. Okie dokie. So that is your 0.25 to tell you very, very weak prescription. We will just try on your other eye now, just before we write your prescription up. Completely up to you whether or not you choose to get the glasses. As I said, it will be, as you can tell, just a minor sort of clarity. Okay, I'll try this line out. So we have without this 1 or 2. Without or 2. 2. Okay. 3. Or 3. Okay, and final one. 0.75 again. We have 2 or 4. 2 or 4. This time. 2 or 4. 2. Wonderful. Okay, so as for your prescription, I'll go and write that up for you, and then I'll send you through to a different optometrist who will be doing your photograph of your eye. Just a small scan, no pain. And they will just check if there's any underlying problems, but also regarding the colour blindness, I see no health issues with your eyesight and the eye health itself. It's more of a slight lifestyle inconvenience. You seem to be able to tell colour pretty well, identifying wise, but I can see that some of them sort of blend into each other a bit, maybe not as sharp as you could see them. Alright, well, I'll get that prescription written up for you and send you through to the other optometrist. One of our customer service team will be meeting you at the desk for payment, and at which point you can go through any glasses options if you're interested. Okay. Well, it's been a pleasure having you, and if you'd like to follow me. Hello, my lovely. Come on in, take a seat. What's your name? It's lovely to meet you. I'm Nurse Michelle. And what is it that you've been sent here today for? Oh, bless you. So you've had a little bit of a fall. You want to show me your wrist? Oh dear. Just a little bit of a graze. Okay, well, we can clean that up for you, and I'll pop a little bandage on. Alright. Before we do, I don't think I've seen you yet this year, have I, for a medical? No. Okay. In that case, my lovely, I'm just gonna do few little tests on you to make sure that you're all healthy. Okay? Great. So firstly, I want to just have a little listen to your tummy. So I'm just going to take my stethoscope. Okay. And if you just lift up your shirt, I'm just going to pop this on your belly. It's a little bit cold, okay? So warm it up a bit for you first. Okay, so I'm just going to pop this on your belly now. To have a little feel of your belly as well, and then I want to listen to your heart and your lungs. So I'm just going to tap very gently on your belly and press a little bit. Okay, it shouldn't hurt, but if it does, just let me know. Is that hurting there? Okay. was the last time that you went to the toilet? That's good. Okay, I'm not going to listen to your heart, so we're going to use the stethoscope again. Keep that top rolled up. Just going to place it here and listen to your heart. Sounds healthy. I'm just going to take this little device here, pop this on your finger, and it's going to just check your heart rate. Okay, pop this on. Good. Meanwhile, I'm just going to have a listen to your lungs as well. Okay, so just keep your breath stable for me. Keep breathing normally. Normally. Okay, and then could you give me a deep breath in? Good, and out. And again, deep breath in. And out. We do one more time. Deep breath in. Gonna reach around behind you here, and again, breathe in normally for me. Good, and then deep breath in and out. Good, and deep breath in, out. Great, let's take that. A little look in your eyes, ears, and throat, okay? So we'll start with your eyes. Okay, so I want you to just look straight behind me, and I'm just gonna flash this light in your eyes a little, okay? Okay. Okay, so again, just keep your head still for me, and what I want you to do is to follow my finger, but just with your eyes, okay? Okay. Good. Okay, last test for your eyes. Again, keeping your head straight, I want you to step behind me. Okay, I'm going to bring my hands into your field of vision. I want you to tell me when you can see them, okay? So, no cheating, keep straight ahead, and just tell me when they come into your vision at the side. Okay, ready? Good. And again. Good. Okay. Top to bottom. Good. And again. Good. Okay. Diagonally. Great. And again. Good job. And the other way. Good. One more time. Well done. Okay, my lovely. Now we're going to have a little look in the back of your throat. So I'm going to take my torch again, and I just want you to open your mouth wide as you can and stick your tongue out. Have we had any sore throats? No. When was the last time that you went to the dentist? Okay, it's been a little while. Make sure that Mummy or Daddy book in an appointment for you. Are we eating lots of sweets? But plenty of fruit and veg. Brushing your teeth. Okay, I don't see anything wrong with that. Great. And then I'm going to have a little look inside your ears. Okay. So we'll start off with this side. I'm just going to come around and have a little look inside your ear. Have you been cleaning your ears at all? Had any problems listening when you're in school? No? Okay. Okay. All right, so we're going to play a little game now. I am going to whisper some words, like Chinese whispers, and I want you to whisper them back to me. Okay? Okay. So, I'm gonna go from ear to ear, and I want you to tell me what word I'm saying. Okay? Flower. Flower, good. Good, okay. Tennis ball. Tennis ball, good. Playground. Playground, okay. Maths. Maths, good. Before I send you back to class, let's get that code sorted for you. Alright, darling. So, I'm just going to clean my hands to make sure that I'm not spreading anything, any nasty germs to you. Okay? Okay, so I'm going to start with some hand gel.
one. So let's first make sure that that coat is all nice and clean and there's no gravel left in it at all. Whereabouts did you fall? Okay. Yeah, so it's more of a graze than a cut, isn't it, really? Is it painful? No. But you were teary before. Was it just the shock? Yeah. Oh, you're so brave because all the tears have stopped now, haven't they? Good. I'm sure you'll be able to go back to class with no trouble. Which hand do you write with? Oh, your right hand. So the cut's on your left, isn't it? So you can still work. I'll make sure that Miss knows that signed you off to work, okay? Alright, my lovely. I'm just going to get a little wipe here. Okay. I'm just going to make sure that that graze is all nice and clean. Now this might sting just a little bit, okay? But you're so brave. So I'm sure you'll be fine. Okay. How's that feeling? Better. Okay. I'm just gonna pop this in the bin. Okay. And just to be sure, I'm gonna wrap you up in a little bandage, okay? Should be enough. Okay.
just gonna walk backwards up now, okay? Gotta stay nice and still. Lovely, you're all done. You can now go back to class. Would you like me to take you? Alright, let's go and find your lollipop. Come on then.
Hi. My name's Sophie. I'll be conducting your ear cleaning today. It's nice to meet you. I believe that you've been having some difficulties with your hearing recently. Well, I'm going to conduct a quick examination of your ears. Then I have a hearing test to go through with you so that we can examine how much the build-up is affecting the hearing. Okay. And then we'll end with the cleaning itself. Alright. So, I want to have a look at your ears. I'm just going to pop some gloves on. It's very windy outside today, isn't it? Can you hear that? Really heavy rain. Christmas is on its way, isn't it? Okay. I'm all prepped. I'm gonna take my otoscope and have a look inside your start off with this here. Okay. As I say, I'm just having a look inside the ear. I can definitely see that large buildup of earwax. When was the last time that you had a cleaning? It's been a very long time. I understand. Okay. Do you attempt to try and clean them at home on your own? Well, I'd always advise against that. Just because we can sometimes exacerbate the problem rather than helping it. Usually you end up pushing the earwax further into the ear. And what kind of tools are you usually using to clean? Yeah. Okay. I could ask you politely to not clean your ear with cotton buds. Just because, again, yeah, sort of causes a bigger issue. Okay. But yes, I can definitely see that there is a consistent amount of buildup in the ears. Is this a persistent problem you've been having? Okay. It might be worth your while to try and book in for consistent routine appointments. So whether it's every 3 months, every 6 months, depending on how quickly the build-up happens. And
That ear does seem a little bit inflamed as well. Have a look at this one. Okay. Yeah, so again, just quite a lot of build up. It's definitely not as bad as the other ear. The inflaming is a little. Okay, so you feel like you can hear better out of this one. Interesting. Again, yeah, you've been cleaning them yourself. Okay. Alright, well, they seem healthy from what I can see, but of course there's quite a bit of build-up and inflammation, so we need to make sure that we can remove that before we can see the problem. Okay. When you last had your cleaning, was there any suspected perforated eardrums or all? No, so it's just the wax build-up that's causing the hearing loss. Okay, I'm gonna clean the outside of your ears now. Alright, and then we'll begin with the hearing test. Okay. This just makes sure that both your ears and the headphones are nicely sanitized before we begin. Let's just get a fresh wipe for the other ear. Okay. Great. Let's just sanitize those headphones. I'm gonna pop these headphones on you now, okay? I'm just gonna grab my notepad and pen, and when I switch the audio on, it's basically gonna go through every step with you, okay? Just pop these on you here. Are you comfortable? Switch them on and we'll begin. Hello. This is your routine beep test. Please follow the instructions given to you by your doctor prior to the test. First test. A series of beeps will occur either on your left or right side. When you hear a beep, please raise either your left or right hand corresponding to where the beep sounds. second test. How many beeps? Beeping will occur of a series of beeps, up to 5 beeps. Once beeping has finished, please raise your hand, indicating how many beeps you heard. This is the end of your test. You may now notify your doctor and remove your headphones. Okay, I'm going to remove the headphones, okay? How was that? Don't worry, we're going to clean those ears now, okay? Right. So, what's going to happen is I'm going to be placing some of this dissolving liquid into your ears. It's completely painless. And what this is going to do is it's going to begin fizzing in your ear canal. Basically going to break down the earwax so that when you dip your head it should naturally flow out, okay? Let's start this side. It should just take a minute. Okay. Okay. Can you hear the fizz? Mm-hmm. So let it do its magic. This ear as well. Okay, great. So we'll give that a moment to work. I'll just prep a few cotton pads just to catch the wax. So we'll start with this ear. Just placing it under like this and just tip your head just a little. That's it. That's it. And just let it stretch out. Here we go. It's coming a little bit stronger now. Just relax. Okay. Just give that a wipe. Give that a wipe. This side now. That's it. Tip your head ever so slightly. That's it. Good. Okay. Just give it a minute. There we go. Alright, there we go. We're all done, okay? See, it wasn't too bad, was it?
gloves off. Okay. Just before I let you go, I just want to do a tiny little quick hearing test with me, okay? Alright. So I'm going to place my hands on either side of your ears, and I want you to tell me whether it's your left or your right that you can hear again. Finally, I'm just going to whisper a few words to you and I want you to repeat them back to me, okay? Alright, start on the side. Relax. Good. Well done. Okay, I think we're all good here. Alright. I'll follow you out and we'll get reception to book you in for another appointment in 3 months' time so we can assess how quickly the build-up is happening. It's been a pleasure. Let's follow me.